shall flow. Rivers of living waters. Oh, he's calling on the Lord of Sata, that the captives may be set free. Oh, the chains will be broken. This is the time, this is the year for our families to be saved and filled with the Holy Ghost. Ah, he's calling. Come on, saints, cry out. Cry out for your loved ones. Cry out for your children. Cry out for your children's children. Cry out. Cry out for your siblings. Robo Santa Lama Delebocosa. Cry out for your parents, your loved ones. This is the day of Rama Sando Bocosa Tara Bahaya. This is the day of Rama Sando Bocosa Taya. This is the day the Lord has made. That our loved ones will be saved. Come on, saints, Sando Borama Sata. We need a divine interception for our loved ones. Oh, Open up to our families the way. Oh.
Thank you.
come against the spirit of death. I hear death by the masses. Physical and spiritual death, come on, cry out against it in the name of Jesus. Say that the Lord rebuke you in the name of Jesus. We come against death, we come against spiritual death, we come against it in the name of Jesus. We come against suicidal death, we come against accidental death in the name of Jesus. Self-afflicted death, we come against the spirit of murder. Come on, children. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we cancel every plot, we cancel every trick, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, across this nation, across this land, in our city, in our homes, we come against death. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, come on, cry out.
Yeah.
pastor yourself.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. We pull down every stronghold in the name of Jesus. We pull it down, we take it down, we render harmless and ineffective in the name of the Lord Jesus. We pull out every strong man in the name of Jesus. We take you down. We come in the name of Jesus. We come in the matchless name. We come in the undefeated name. We come in the name above every name. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we come against you, Satan. Right now in Jesus' name, you can't have my children. You cannot have my children's children. You cannot have this nation. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. We say God is the Lord over this nation, over this land, over the government, over the city, over the state. Jesus is Lord. To the glory of God the Father, we decree and declare it. We speak it and it is so. In the name of Jesus, we decree and it is established that Jesus is Lord in our homes, in our churches, in the name of Jesus, in every community, every home for Christ. Oh, glory God. Every home for Jesus, every home for Christ. We decree and declare it in the name of Jesus. We come against witchcraft in the name of Jesus. We bring you down. We render you harmless and ineffective. We come against spiritual blindness. We render you harmless and ineffective. And we speak life in the name of Jesus. We speak Jesus. Come on. Call his name. We call his name. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess in hallelujah that Jesus is Lord. Demons tremble at the sound. Come on, saint, call his name. Call his name. Jesus. Take over our churches. In the name of Jesus. Take over every pulpit. In the name of Jesus. Let Christ arise and his enemies be scattered. God.
Let it be.
formed against our families. No weapons formed against our communities. No weapons formed against us shall prosper. In the name of Jesus, every plot, every trick, every scheme, every word spoken against us, we paralyze it, we nullify it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, a bloodstream, a purge from sickness and disease. In the name of Jesus. Come on, saints. There's a clarion call to answer. Church, every home, over our children and our children's children. We speak healing. We come against mental illness. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We thank you for the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. Let this mind be in you, which is also in Christ Jesus, who thought it not robbery to be equal with God. We thank you for the mind of Christ. We thank you for the anointing of Christ that find the necessity to pray. Oh, glory to God. Who found the necessity to fast, my God, and go along and seek the Father's face. Put that anointing on us, God, to see the need, to see the necessity, to steal away and seek your face, to turn over the plate and seek your face. Hallelujah. That same anointing that was on Jesus, my God, hallelujah, who only said what you told him to say and who only did what you told him to do, put it on us, God. Put it in us, God, in the name of Jesus, to only say what you tell us to say, to only do what you tell us to do. Put it in us. Put it in us. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. hands wherever you are. Come on, let's go into a deeper level of praise. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, let's give him a fresh yes. Hallelujah. Every hour I need you. nuestra.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And I think about the goodness of Jesus. Come on, saints, you ought to thank him. Hallelujah. How many walked in here this morning? You ought to give him glory. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. In Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I thank God today. Who's ever praying for my strength and energy? Keep on. I feel strong in the Lord. I'm not tired or sleepy. Woo, glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Keep praying for me. I want to be energized. When it comes time to prayer, I want energy. Woo, glory. When it comes time to praise, I want energy. I want to give him everything. Woo.
To the So whenever I came in and was on my mind, all of that is dissipated. It's gone. It's gone because this is all about Him. Hallelujah. His glory. Hallelujah. He deserves all the glory. He deserves all the praise. The honor all day belongs to Him. Glory is all about you, Jesus.
Into this holy place. Yeah. this room. Feel it all around. Kurabashi
Please. Thank you. prayer meeting. I've been longing for it for years. And I'm dancing because he brought that desire to pass. The saints praying, sing and worship. Give him a dance because he's worthy. Amen. How many love him today? Amen. How many glad he first loved you? Thank you, Jesus. Well, praise God. I don't know if the pastor wants to come up now. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're so thankful for the praise team. Hallelujah. And all the prayer warriors from various parts of the city. Amen. So happy for Sister Chloe Brown Allen. Amen. She's here this morning. Sister Trent. Full gospel's in the house. Let's see. My mic can't see you, but thank you for being here. Amen. We're so thankful. Amen. I know the Spirit of the Lord is in this house. Thank you, Jesus. Where His Spirit is, there is liberty, there's freedom, there's deliverance. Amen. There are answers. And I tell you, when I saw Sister Yasmin going forth the other day, that was awesome. Somebody look and see if there's a hole in that rug over there. But she cut it. She went in. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Well, we praise God for this opportunity to be here. Amen. Father, we just thank you for your word. It's true. Your word that will live and stand forever. We ask that your word go forth with no hindrances, no confusion. But it'll go forth and bring yokes and set captives free. Father, we thank you now in Jesus' name. Amen. I felt impressed to just do a little teaching on angels. I believe in lieu of the fact that our nation is really afraid, even from children to adults. They are afraid. We have children that saying to each other, well, if I don't see you in school tomorrow, I'll see you in Mexico. And the kids are afraid of what has taken place in our nation as far as our election. Also, I got an email the other day from a prayer leader from one of the largest churches in Tulsa. And in her email, she's encouraging the saints to continue to pray. And a serious prayer, and I felt this also in my spirit, that once the power has been transferred, violence might take place. What we see now is kind of calm or whatever, a little bit of violence, but in her email she was expressing that a lot of violence may take place once that inauguration. We want our prayers to precede us. I remember, like it was yesterday, the night we get ready to hit 911. I was at that time, my time would start about 10 o'clock. I started to wake up about 10 o'clock p.m. And I can remember that at midnight, I heard in my spirit, there's death in the air. Death is in the air, and I began to pray, of course, for everybody I knew in this nation, our president, just praying, praying, praying up until 3 o'clock that morning. And I can remember at being at school, I was at Marshall Elementary, and one of the co-workers walked in and began to tell me how they had hit the towers and this and that. And I knew immediately that was what the Spirit of the Lord had told me. Death is in the air. And I said, Lord, if I really understood what you were saying, I would have went out on my sidewalk and just cried out. But the Spirit of the Lord said, you did your part. And so I never want to be in a place where I haven't done my part, you know, in praying and crying out. I remember a friend of mine was on my heart so strong, and I just didn't want to call him because once we get on the phone, we start talking, and it's late. Again, I was a late person then. But she was on my heart so strong. I'm saying this for a purpose. When people are on your heart, you need to follow through. And I even picked up the phone and just hung up, so nah, I don't feel like it. We get on the phone, we'll be on for 2 or 3 hours. I didn't know that my friend was on her deathbed. And she was trying to remember my number. And she was trying to tell her pastor parts of the number. She couldn't remember it. And then they was trying to look it up in the phone book. And I regret to say that the call that I did get was that she had went on. And so it's important that when things are on our heart, that we follow through with a show enough prayer. You know, not just throw something out there, but if someone is on your heart really strong, it's imperative that you go in and pray. The Lord should lead you to make a phone call or a visit. Please follow through. We never know what people are going through. And so I feel in my heart whenever my pastor released me that there's a teaching on corporate prayer. Because sometimes when the prayer leader is praying, we may not understand the direction they're going. But if we as the body of Christ will learn how to follow that, I tell you, there's some powerful anointing. We will see, amen, a manifestation of God when we learn to just do that corporate prayer and go in into agreement. But sometimes we think, well, I just want to pray for my family right now. She's talking about praying for the nation. But if we'll learn to follow, if you trust the prayer leader, if you learn and that they're hearing from God, if you'll learn to follow that, amen, we will see a manifestation of God. How many can say amen?
Amen.
I was blessed in my study on angels. I don't think that we remember as we should what angels do. You know, I heard people say, well, you have one on the left and one on the right. But in my study, I found out that there are thousands and thousands of angels. Amen. And so it's not just one or two that look like Incredible Hulk in our human mind, but God, he does more than enough. Amen. And so there are thousands and legions of angels. The one scripture, if you're taking notes, and I'm asking my reader to read for me today. We want to start in Psalm 148, verse 2 and verse 5. We know that angels originated from God. God created angels. Amen. He created Satan himself, who was an angel, right? And all the angels that decided to follow Satan today, they are demons. So you know, if angels are in the thousands, you can imagine how many rose up with Satan to come against God. And so now we have thousands and thousands of demonic forces, which were previous angels. But let's look at Psalm 148 and verse 2, if you'll read for me, please. For the sake of time. Yes.
Verse 2.
Yes.
Psalm 148, verse 2. Praise ye him, all his angels. Praise ye him, all his host. Mm-hmm. Praise ye him, sun and moon. Praise him, all ye stars of light. Praise him, ye heavens of heavens, and ye waters that be above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created.
Amen. God commanded and they were created. The stars, the moon, amen, the angels. You know, it's a song that says it's incredible that the ocean know just how far to go. You know, nobody has a time clock. Say when it's daylight and when it's night, or when the moon should come and when the sun should come. God spoke all of that into existence and is still following his command. How many love him? When we think about that, think about whatever you're going through. If God could speak that into existence and is still obeying Him, how come your situation is so difficult? He's the same God. Amen. Let's build our faith this morning. He's the same God. Then He transfers some power to us, right? We can decree a thing and it shall be what? The same God. Hallelujah. Let us speak into your life today. Speak to your situation and tell them who's Lord of Lords and King of Kings. Amen. For the sake of time, you can write this down. Colossians 1:16. For by Him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by Him and for Him. They were created to worship Him. Yes. Amen. And this is God's organization of angels. They are, this is God's organizational chart, let me say that. And let me say this, just as God is organized, we have to remember we have an enemy that's just as organized. Amen. So the next time we want to study about Satan and his demons, because he has an organization. And sometimes we say that old stupid devil, that old dumb devil, but he know what to do to get to you. If you let him. Amen. So we're not exalting him, but we're talking about the power of God. Amen. Ephesians 3:10, for by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. I just read the same scripture. The reference, cross-reference to that is Ephesians 3:10. Then I just want to speak briefly on the classification of angels, and then there's a particular set of angels I want us to really talk about, and that's the angels that are messengers. I'm going to come back to that. Then we also have elect angels, 1 Timothy 5:21. Will you turn to that for me, please, sister?
1 Timothy 5:21.
Yes.
1 Timothy 5:21.
I charge thee before God and the Lord Jesus Christ and the elect angels, thou observe these things without preferring one before another, doing nothing by partiality.
That whole scripture will preach. We're talking about the elect angels, and that's the only time they are mentioned. Amen. So the first order of angels, or one order in the organization of angels, is the elect angels. And then we have the cherubim. Can you turn to, there are several references for those who are taking notes. One is Genesis 3:24. The next one is Exodus 25:18-22, if I'm going too fast. The next one is Ezekiel 1:3-28, and Ezekiel 10:22. And I like the way Ezekiel describes the angels. I can remember a time I could read the scriptures and think, ooh, why would God do that? But in his infinite wisdom, he does what he do. Amen. So he tells, Ezekiel describes four appearances of angels. One he describes as the face of a lion. One he describes the face of an ox. The next one is the face of a man. And another one, the face of an angel. Now, one thing I do want to say, if you don't know the spirit realm, this might sound kind of like, ugh, I don't know how you feel about it. But when you see in the spirit realm, you probably want something. You probably want an angel like looking like this to combat for you in the spirit realm. One thing that the body of Christ is missing is that we are so focused on the natural, that we forget there is a spirit realm.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And the spirit realm is real. Come on, saints of God. You know, we even put God in our natural thoughts without even thinking about it. I was describing the other night in a class how some people don't understand the love of God. Because, and I had asked, challenged the students to ask God to manifest his love to them. Then the Spirit of the Lord said to me, let them know it's not like their natural parents or a natural love they might have experienced. In the sense that, now this is an old school term, how many ever got a whooping from your parents? We used to say whooping. And how many at the end of that whooping, your mom or dad would say, now I love you, and that's why I'm whooping you. And you think, don't love me so much? Can you show me love in a different manner? And so people think that if I ask God to manifest his love to me, help us Jesus, he might send me through a trial that's so difficult, I can't see straight. And then at the end tell me, see how I love you. But God is saying he's not like those natural parents. Come on here. By his goodness, he's drawn us. Hallelujah. We don't have to go through a deep, dark trial just to know God is love. Amen. I receive it now when everything is going well. I receive it if I'm going through. God, you are love. And I can't compare him to a human love. There's your deliverance. Take it. Thank you, Jesus. So we're talking about the cherubims. We're talking about how Ezekiel described these four beings. But let's go to Revelation 4:6. And we're talking about living creatures surrounding the throne of God. I do feel I'm struggling a little bit, but I'm going to be like the Baptist preacher. My help is coming. I feel my help coming. Thank you, Lord. All right, so we have it here. Come on, reader.
And before the throne, there was a sea of glass like unto crystal. And in the midst of the throne, and around about the throne, were four beasts
so
full of eyes.
Who's on the throne? Who's on the throne? We're talking about around the throne. We're talking about in heaven, around the throne, there are what? Four what?
Four beasts.
Full of what?
Eyes before and behind.
Keep going. Is that all of it?
And the first beast was like a lion. And the second beast like a calf. And the third beast had a face as a man. And the fourth beast was like a flying eagle.
The same thing Ezekiel describes. But the thing that stood out to me is that they are surrounding the throne with all of these eyes. And I say, God, why so many eyes? I don't know what, I think I had the King James, but it to me it seemed like eyes was all over, everywhere. I said, God, why so many eyes? And this is what dropped to me. The eyes of the Lord run to and fro. Seeking those. I'm just telling you what came to me. Seeking those whose heart is right before him. And when our hearts are right before him, he manifests himself and answers prayers. How many love him? That's around God. The four beasts with all these eyes are around God. Amen. His eyes are everywhere. How many love Jesus today? Those are cherubims. Those are around the throne. But let's look at seraphims. And let's go to Isaiah 6:2. And verse 6. Remember, the cherubims are around the throne. In Isaiah chapter 6 and verse 2. Go ahead, reader.
Chapter 6, verse 2. Above it stood the seraphims. Each one had six wings. With twain he covered his face. And with twain he covered his feet. And with twain he did fly. And one cried unto another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory.
The whole earth is what?
Full of his glory.
Okay, the seraphims are above the throne. So we got cherubims around, seraphims above. And what are they saying above the throne?
Holy, holy, holy.
Uh-huh. Is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is what? Full of his glory. Heaven is the worship place of God. Amen. He's been worshiped. He's being worshiped both day and night. We were created, amen, to worship him. Hallelujah. The next time you're not getting a breakthrough, check your worship life. Worshiping him for who he is. Amen. For what he's done. Hallelujah. In spirit and in truth. Give him worship. Give him praise. Hallelujah. Because he's worthy. From the rising of the sun until the going down of the same, he's worthy to be praised. So if we're stuck, look like we can't get a breakthrough, check your worship life. Amen. Are we murmuring? Are we complaining? Are we on the phone with Mother May I so she can tell you what your next step is? Are we looking for answers from Deacon Cornbread and Deacon Mashed Potatoes? Where is your worship life? Amen. There's no way you can worship God and not get a breakthrough. Because God inhabits the praises of his people. And when God comes through and get right in your face, because you're worshiping him in his face, and God is so big and bad, when he sit down and take in all that worship, what do you think is going to happen all around him? It's got to fall. Amen. Check your worship life. Hallelujah. I'm talking about in spirit and in truth. When nobody else can see you. See, this is an overflow. Thank you, God. The dance already took place before I got here. Hallelujah. Yeah, I'm just in a corporate worship right now, but before I got here, I was already in a worship. I'd already cut my step and gave him some glory. Now that I come here, it's an overflow. Amen. And some of us need to get out of ourselves. You know, the more you seek God, the more he'll show you. How we caught up about what people think. How we caught up how people see us. But at the end of the day, you're not going to stand before people. And you sure enough can't use them as an excuse. It's between you and him. Hallelujah. Somebody give him some love right now. Thank you, God. We need some true worship. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. Glory. Where everything is involved. Yeah. I need a breakthrough because there are times I just want to lay out on my face and give him a worship. I'm talking about here in my overflow time. So I have no problem in that private worship. But here I want to get on my face. And just lay out and cry holy.
Yes, holy. Hallelujah, Jesus.
See, I need a breakthrough because I am thinking about what people might think. I'm just keeping it real. Sometimes I'm too transparent. I got in trouble for being too transparent. But anyway, I'm just saying. I know y'all don't feel that way, but I'm just saying. We need to come out of ourselves and give God some praise. Amen. He's worthy. Glory to God. You can't call on people if you're in serious trouble. The best they can do is, girl, I'll be praying for you. I'll be in agreement. And they go. So you better give God what belongs to him. How many can say amen? Hallelujah. Every time we come together, it should be a praise. It should be so strong that we don't even want to stop. I'm looking for that day too. And a prayer service where we just can't stop. Hallelujah. The presence of the Lord is so strong. And the saints are in true worship. We can't stop. The musicians won't get tired. They can't stop. If we don't do that right now, God forbid a day will come when we run to the church and we sure can't stop. Because what's out there won't be pretty. Amen. I'm not teaching gloom and doom. I'm talking about Jesus is coming soon. And we can't afford to tiptoe through the tulips and think if we give God a patty cake, we've done some worship. I'm talking about worship where your belly is sore. Amen. I'm talking about you crying out so strong, you think you're going to lose your breath. See, it don't take all of that. You're absolutely right. It takes more. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Is there some demonic activities out there? That it's going to take the power and the anointing of God to destroy them. And unfortunately, some of them are not too far from the church. It's a lot of bondage in the church. Come on here. And there ought to be enough power. Ooh, glory to God. In the church that people come and they're bound by addictions. And immoral lifestyles. Come on here. But the power of God is so strong, they break free. We don't have to lay hands. We don't have to call them out. Just the power of God flowing through the saints. Come on, saints. I heard a minister criticizing the song, There's Power in the Name of Jesus. To, what's the rest of it? Break every yoke? Break every chain. And he was saying, well, Jesus already broke the chain. That's a cute song, but we don't need to sing it. And I prayed about it because it bothered me. Because on one hand, I understand the preacher. He's right. Jesus has broken every chain. But I said, but Lord, the song has helped so many people. You know, why should we stop? You know, why are we singing it? And the Lord said, you might know, or some others may understand that I've broken every chain, but there are so many who do not know it. Everybody haven't applied it. Amen. And so that set me free, because people will come against me because I say prayer warriors. They don't like that war. You know, Jesus has defeated all of that. Well, you're right, but everybody's not applying that. Everybody's not living up to that, so until we all reach, we need some prayer warriors who will go in the heavenly realms, in the spirit realm, and tear down strongholds. Come on here. Thank you, Jesus. Then I always refer back, put it on the screen in case so I can see if I'm right. Exodus 15:3.
that says our God is a God of war. War does not bother God. As long as he understands, I don't care about anybody else. When you don't want to come against prayer warriors, God is a God of war. Am I right? I was right. The Lord is a man of what? War. The Lord is his name. We need prayer warriors. We need people who will travail at birth until baby Christians come on out the nursery. Don't get me started on the nursery. We're my Bible study, Bible college students with that nursery. Now we got saints in the nursery that should be at the table. Come on, we're immature. We're fickle. We're not steady in our standards. Come on here. And we want to stay in the nursery where we're spoon fed and give us a formula. But God needs the body of Christ to be in a position where we can eat some meat. Come on here. And pray through. And see the salvation of the Lord. Y'all don't want to hear me today. I'm going to be like the old mother. I'm going to go church mother on you. Y'all don't want to hear me. But the church needs to grow up. Amen. We need to make room for people to come in that's coming off the street. If we in church fussing and fighting, can't have a good kitchen committee. Come on. We don't have room for people to come in off the street. But we need to grow up where we're seeking God no matter what. Amen. And giving him worship. Not standing around looking at the praise team. I just wanted to go wild and crazy this morning when the praise team was going forth. Because I'm not looking at them. Yes. Words have power. Yes. And they were singing powerful words. Yes. We need to take those words and grasp it and put it in our hearts and live it. Yes. And shout to God. Yes. You shouldn't come in here with a prayer request and leave still trying to figure out how it's going to happen. You should walk out with a victorious praise. That whatever I came in here with, it's a wrap now. Yeah. Glory to God. God has already answered. He's already brought it to pass. I'm not waiting to see with my natural eye. I know what happened in the spirit realm when I say there's victory in the name of Jesus. Come on, saints. We stand still too much. Come on here. It ought to be a fire in our belly. If you were truly on fire, you wouldn't be standing there. If you were naturally on fire, you gonna stand there and do that? We couldn't catch you. You will stop, drop, and roll. And hope the saints come to your rescue, beating the fire out. Come on here. Take that in the spirit realm. There's not enough covers to cover me because I'm rolling. I'm running. I'm screaming. I'm shouting. Because the fire of God is up on me. How many love him? We need some fire in our churches. So how you know? I just know. I know by the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Now let's talk about angels that are messengers, and I'm finished. And I want to say that there is a deeper study. I mean, I could go several weeks just teaching that, but I felt to just kind of
kind of just give you a little bit of something today. But let's talk about our angels that are messengers. And these are the angels that are surrounding us as believers. And let's go to Daniel 7, verse 10. These are the angels that relate to us, especially when we're doing spiritual warfare. Now, I know some of you probably want to pray all the time. And you're always in your word. And you always want to be at Bible study and prayer. But I know sometimes I have to say, God put it in me. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Amen. And y'all stood there like, mm-hmm. Yeah. But if it's not for you, it's for me. God put the want to in here. Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Oh, yeah. And I said, why does it take? I'm talking to God now. You put it in me to want to read when I know that there's power in your word. And the thought that comes back to me is that the Bible is not something you just read and close the book and say, okay, what's on TV right now? See, when you really go in, and I'm talking about just a basic read. I'm not talking about a Bible study where you're looking up words and you have your, the things can't come to me now. I won't say Bible dictionary, but there's another one. Concordance. I'm not talking about when you're going through. I'm talking through all of that. I'm talking about a basic read. For me, I just can't read it and say, okay, next, what's on TV? I mean, I want it to go down in my belly. Are you with me? It's not a recipe book. I heard somebody describe it like that. Well, you know, sometimes reading the Bible like reading a recipe book. No. If you got that spirit, you sure enough need some deliverance. Because it's better than that. So you want to read. And when you read, it takes everything, all of your focus, your thoughts, your mind, your will. Every part of your being has to be in that read. And some people don't want to commit to that. They want to read enough to say, okay, I read. And God is calling us deeper. How many know that's the truth? Deep is calling unto deep. As the noise of many waters. Psalm 42. We like that first part. As the deer panted for the water. We can sing that. But you keep on reading where God says deep is calling unto deep. When he's calling you to another level of prayer. And another level of praise. See, and in that same psalm, it talks about water spouts. I'm going to get to angels. But I'm going to go where he's telling me right now. Water spouts, tell me students, it's a tornado on water, right? And if you get a tornado on water, everything in its way will be destroyed. And the reason why God is calling deep unto deep is because sometimes we go through water spouts. Where it seems like everything around us is being destroyed. That's why he's calling you to go deeper. Come on here. Deeper in your prayer life. But let me say this. In the midst of that water spout, if anybody going through one, just see the hand of God right down in the middle of it. He's taking care of you.
Glory.
He's loving on you. Hallelujah. And whatever you're going through, it's not too difficult if you give it to him. Amen. Now let's talk about angels that are messengers. When we're in spiritual warfare, someone wrote the song that says, while I'm on my knees praying, God sends an angel. Put the angel on the run.
And by the time I get up from praying, Minister Cherry, what I've been praying for is already done. We need to see that. So what happens in Daniel chapter 7, verse 10? Come on, reader.
A fiery stream issued and came forth from before him. Mm-hmm. Thousands ministered unto him.
Okay, thousands. Thousands. Come on. Ministered unto him. And how many?
And 10,000 times 10,000 stood before him. Uh-huh. The judgment was set and the books were opened.
Hallelujah. Thousands upon thousands. We're talking about the spirit realm for a believer. That's the spiritual warfare. Now these thousands will interpret God's will. They will protect. They will provide guidance. They will bring answers to prayer. Thank you, Jesus. They will announce. They will warn. They will instruct. They will also bring judgment. They will encourage. They will sustain. They will deliver and move on the behalf of believers. And you mean to tell me you don't want to do spiritual warfare? Amen. Thousands upon thousands, and then 10,000s are being released when we do spiritual warfare, when we're going in prayer, and we're praying on the behalf of others. We're praying about our nation. So you got to see movement in the spirit realm. You can't think as you're right here and you're praying and you don't see what's going on outside, that nothing is happening. You've got to know that when you get down on your knees and say, Satan, I bind you in the name of Jesus. I rebuke death. You got to see it happening. Spiritual death. People blinded to the truth. Come on here if you don't think that's real. Physical death. Suicidal death. And it's not just in one race nowadays. You better wake up. All the immoralities. Death to those immoralities. And unfortunate, they're not too far from the church. God help us today. So you better know that when you're praying, things are happening in the spirit realm. I'm going to say it again. They interpret God's will. They protect, provide guidance, bring answers to prayer, announce, warn, instruct, bring judgment, encourage, sustain, deliver, and move on the behalf of believers. We don't have to be afraid. And I'm not just saying God has not given us a spirit of fear. One of the things that just came to me lately, I know it's been true forever, for a long time, that saints just know what to say. Oh, God, haven't given me a spirit of fear. We know to say that. Sometimes we just know what to do. We know proper protocol. But I'm talking about waking up. Arise, O church, out of your slumber and your sleep. And realize there's a spirit realm out there that if you don't use the authority that God has given you, come on, you will regret that you didn't press in prayer. Amen. There's a press in prayer. It don't come just light. Oh yeah, I'm ready to get up 5 o'clock in the morning and go in. Sometimes it's like, Lord, give me the strength. Come on here. Sometimes it's, and then not using an alarm clock. I mean a natural waking up to go into the presence of God. Thank you, Lord. God has to put that in you. How many want it in you today?
Amen. I could go deeper even in that scripture. Like I said, it's a whole teaching on angels. Amen. But my point today was just to encourage you that when we are doing warfare, amen, God is moving on our behalf. You have to see your family saved. I expect a phone call. Every time I come here and pray, and I'm praying for my relatives, I leave here expecting a phone call. Guess what? I accepted Christ today. Amen. Guess what? I gave up smoking just like that. I know all y'all family saved and do all those righteous things. But I got some family members keep my prayer wheel turning. They're not bad people, but they're not saved. Amen. So you have to expect that. I expect for them to come and say, I gave my life to Christ. I'm listening now to the preacher who, even if it's on television, I'm listening now. And I'm learning. And I now start to pray. I'm talking about, these are real testimonies I just got the other day. People still attached to things. People still that need a chain broken from addiction. Yet they're telling me, I'm getting up early now. And they can call some of the preacher's name and I'm listening and it's helping me. That's my expectation. And I look to see and hear them say, guess what? I gave my all to Christ. I decided a long time ago, Sister Brianna, that I would refuse to get up and pray and not see answers. I might as well sleep in and get up just in time to go to work. But if I would get up off and pray to a holy God, hey, and he's just not God, but he's my Abba Father, I expect answers. Because he's true to his word. He's not a man that he should lie. Neither the son of man that he has to repent. Or like men that he has to repent. But whatever he's spoken, that's what he'll do. Whatever he said, he will bring it to pass. We don't have to fear. And we're not praying because we're afraid. You can pray because you're worried. We're not worrying praying. We're praying in faith. With our focus on God. With our affection set on things above and not on the things of this earth. How many can say amen? We're praying because we have a relationship with God. God the Father, God the Son. God the Holy Spirit. We're not praying because we're fearful. We're praying because, I don't know your testimony, but mine is I'm in love. Yeah. Put that out. I'm in love. I found the one whom I long for. It is better over me is love, Jehovah. The Lord my banner. Hallelujah. That's why we pray. Then we intercede because there are those who don't know how. Amen. There are people who are lost who don't know how. We intercede because we don't want to see people lost. If it's right in my living room, I don't want to see people lost. Thank you, Jesus. If it's in my classroom, I don't want to see them lost. So we intercede. We intercede for a nation who may not know how to call upon a holy God. So we stand in the gap. Come on, people. It's not a game. It's not something to pass the time away. But it's real. Come on, stand on your feet and pray with me. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Come
Come on, saints. Sometimes we get too tired when it comes to the things of God. I can't tell you how many people was announcing how they were at 5 o'clock in the morning cooking for Thanksgiving. And those same people will come to me and say, "Will you pray for me? I sure don't have a prayer life." I'm serious. Real serious. I know I need to pray more. You'll be surprised at the people who honored the Black Friday, who will stand in line for hours and won't give God 10 minutes. Come on, saints. We'll laugh and giggle all day with our loved ones. No condemnation. But we won't give God 5 minutes. That's why we have to say, "God, put it in me." It's easy to follow the flesh. Come on. You know I'm right. People will spend, true testimony, 4 hours in one store shopping and won't give God 4 minutes. It's time to wake up, church. Who do we really love? Jesus said, "If you don't love me more than your mother," I'm talking about what Jesus said. Somebody can find and read it. "More than your father, more than your sister and your brother, you're none of mine." Jesus said that. I mean, Jesus was hardcore. He spoke where it'll touch your soul. We made them to be fluffy and puffy, and oh, he understands. But God said to me one day, "I'll tell you what I understand. I understand my word." Thank you, Jesus. I stopped telling people God understands. If it's not according to the word, he's not understanding that, because he gave you his word. Come on here. God says, "I understand my word. Flee. Run from it." Talking about fornication. You know, people come to you single, want to tell you things. "Well, God understands." No, he don't. He understands. He told you to flee. Run like in terror. That's what he understands. Thank you, God. You better love him. He's real. And we think that Jesus hasn't returned because he wants more people to get saved, and I believe that's true. But the church needs to get right. We might be the holdup, because we playing games when he's serious. Come on here. Somebody sing the song. The reason I read his word. I would sing it if I could remember the tune. I read his word because I don't want to be lost. Thank you, God. I don't want to be lost when Jesus comes. Thank you, Lord. The reason I pray like I pray, I don't want to be lost when Jesus comes. How many want to be rightly related? In position where you should be. Ooh, glory to God. How many want to be that intercessor that he can call? You can pray those 3 hours, still not really touching what God has said, but yet you did your part. How many ready? Be ready for the blessings. We like those pump up talks, and I like them too. But we cannot do all of that without holiness. Because most preaching, not in my church, but most preaching is motivational speaking. And the
church don't know the difference. Most preaching is motivational speaking. They can rhyme. They can put a little tune to it. And the church don't know the difference. God help us. God help us. Thank you, Jesus. We need to say the power of Jesus' name will break every chain, even if it's on my thoughts, my mind, my will, my emotions. Break every chain. I forgot to do that in my teaching, how angels will open prison doors. We know it. Thank you, Jesus, how they will appear in answer to prayer. We know it. Let's live like it. Come on, somebody, let's go in our prayer language. Oh God, we thank you today. We praise you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, this is a 4-hour vigil. Don't give up. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. In my spirit. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, sing to the Lord a new song. He has done wonderful things. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, we love you, Jesus. We love you. Join in, there's a sound, but
that needs to be heard in the spirit realm.
The Spirit of the Lord is coming in like a great flood. Riata, Orianda, Riando, Riase, Riata, to do a washing on the able to save your soul, your mind, your will, your emotions. God wants you free. Receive his word. Receive the 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 word. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, saints. Come on, saints. Let's go in. Hallelujah. Jesus, even in your relationships, God is speaking peace in the name of Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We speak singleness of heart in every relationship. In the name of Jesus. No division. We cancel division in every home and every relationship. In the name of Jesus, we release your sweet peace. We release your sweet peace. Hallelujah. Somebody say peace. Hallelujah. Peace like the river. Hallelujah. Hey, what sweet peace. should not fall. I love it. He's watching you that you don't stumble. Some of you need to step out by faith, but you're afraid of failure. But he's watching you. That you might not fail, that you might not fall, that you might not stumble. You better receive the Lord with meekness. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Some of you need to know you're more than a pew warmer. But there are gifts that the body of Christ needs. Thank you, Jesus. Some of you in your quiet time, the Spirit of the Lord is going to meet you there. If you just give it to him. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. You're going to feel a presence so sweet. In fact, it's right here, right now. Take it. And pain should be gone right now because there's a sweet spirit here. It's sweet, I know. Broken hearts should be mended right about now because there's a sweet spirit here. Some of you regret going home. God says there's a sweet spirit that's gonna fill the room. Every room in your home will be sweet. If that was you, I'll take it. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, join me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. On one accord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Woo, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, feel the room. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You know what happens? When we get on one accord, the room will shake. Come on. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on from your belly. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Come on, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, one accord. Thank you, Jesus. thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Come on from your heaven. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. For my pastor. Thank you, Jesus.
Into the discipline of fasting. Amen. To break those yokes and loose those bands and give you a heart for the poor and needy. And amen. Cause true repentance to take place. So we're working through those old lessons that we've learned many years ago. Amen. How to get results from God through fasting and prayer. It's going to take hard praying, strong crying out, travail in prayer, weeping and wailing. People don't hear people, that's Old Testament. But look in the book of Jeremiah, because of the sins and the abominations that we are dealing with today. It's time for us to howl and weep and cry, pray. Amen. And I believe that with fasting, prayer, seeking God, and stand before the Lord, I believe that the answer, amen, is on its way. I mean, complete breakthrough. How many want to see complete breakthrough? Our saints will, amen, really not just pray a few crocodile tears and just say, I apologize for all of my many years of fruitlessness and neglect and backsliding. I apologize. That's the way the saints do it now. Amen. But it takes fasting and prayer and seeking God sometimes for weeks and months before you can get released from your, amen, your, what you call it, backsliding. Sometimes we're in a rut. How many can say amen? Get out of the rut, you're going to have to what? Persevere. You're going to have to weep and howl and cry like a woman in travail. I don't know how that feels, but I do know when I cry out, amen, in travail, my inside constricts. Amen. It hurts on the inside. Amen. How many experience that pain and agony in your spirit today? If you didn't, just keep on pushing the plate back. Stay in your word. Amen. And ask God for a burden for the lost. I believe that something is going to take place that will help us to make that song, take me back. Take me back, dear Lord. To the place where I first received. I believe, how many want to go back? I mean, to that brokenness and that whole hunger, craving for souls. And the thing that brought Sodom down, the Bible says, fullness of bread. No, pride first. Pride when you got all you think you need. Amen. Pride, fullness of bread, abundance of idleness. Amen. And even failure to strengthen the hand of the poor needed. That's where we are. Failure to strengthen the hand of the poor and the needy. Amen. That means people that need to be saved, people that need help. They'll never change. You know, God, the Bible says God has, chosen the what? The poor of this world, what? Rich in faith. There are a lot of poor people destined to be saved, but somebody got to carry the gospel. Somebody have to have a passion and a burden for the lost. Amen. How many can say, like Jesus, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Amen. He has anointed me to preach the gospel. How many can say that to the poor? How many can say, I've been anointed to preach the gospel to the poor? If that anointing is not on you, you better pray that the anointing come back on you again. Crying and weeping and moaning and travailing for the lost. Amen. That's when your breakthrough and your health and your delight shall spring forth speedily. Fasting and prayer. If you don't have that book, that spiritual breakthrough, amen, deals with fasting and deal with all types of prayers that we need to get. Praise the Lord. Amen. All right, Sister Deborah, you're going to have last words, but we just want you to bring your
home. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you, shine his face upon you and be gracious to you. We speak blessings over your life in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you.